Hello, good evening. It is my 322nd daily reading, and I'm going to read out of Don't Sweat the Small Stuff, and It's All Small Stuff, Simple Ways to Keep the Little Things from Taking Over Your Life by Richard Carlson, PhD. All right, this one is called Remember That You Become What You Practice Most. Repeated practice is one of the most basic principles of most spiritual and meditative paths. In other words, whatever you practice most is what you will become. If you are in the habit of being uptight whenever life isn't quite right, repeatedly reacting to criticism by defending yourself, insisting on being right, allowing your thinking to snowball in response to adversity, or acting like life is an emergency, then, unfortunately, your life will be a reflection of this type of practice. You will be frustrated because, in a sense, you have practiced being frustrated. Likewise, however, you can choose to bring forth in yourself qualities of compassion, patience, kindness, humility, and peace. Again, through what you practice. I guess it's safe to say that practice makes perfect. It makes sense, then, to be careful what you practice. Sounds a lot like the law of attraction. This isn't to suggest that you make your entire life into a great big project where the goal is to be constantly improving yourself. Only that it's immensely helpful to become conscious of your own habits, both internal and external. Where is your attention? How do you spend your time? Are you cultivating habits that are helpful to your stated goals? Is what you say you want your life to stand for consistent with what your life really stands for? Simply asking yourself these and other important questions and answering them honestly helps to determine which strategies will be most useful to you. Have you always said to yourself, I'd like to spend more time by myself, or I've always wanted to learn to meditate, yet somehow you've never found the time? Sadly, many people spend far more time washing their car or watching reruns on television shows they don't even enjoy than they do making time for aspects of life that nurture their hearts. If you remember that what you practice you will become, you may begin choosing different types of practice. And if you remember your thoughts become things, you might be more mindful of your thoughts as well. So, this brings up a good point. We are constantly saying, when I have more time, I'll do this, that, or the other thing, right? But somehow we never quite manage to find more time. We obviously can't create more time, right? So, if you find something that you want to do that you think could help improve your life, the best thing you can do for yourself is to think of something that you can take away from, like your time spent doing a certain thing. So, for example, if, like it mentioned, you want to start meditating, then, and you find yourself coming straight home from work and having dinner and plopping down in front of the TV for 3 hours before bed, well, what can you do? You can decide to take away 1 hour of that television time and use it in learning meditation, perhaps, watching videos about it, reading about it, and practicing it. So, you really have to make room for the things that you find more important. That's all there is to it. You can never add an hour to your day, so you have to subtract something from it that you find less important. So you have to weigh the benefits, the pros and cons. What's going to benefit you in your life more? Sitting in front of the television for that extra hour? Or perhaps meditating or reading a book or something? It's really all there is to it. It's pretty easy, actually, when you think about it. You make things seem so much more difficult than they actually are. I tell you, it's true. It's all about mindset. Anyways, I'm sending out love, light, and healing energy as that you pass it on and pay it forward. Or pay it forward and pass it on. Until tomorrow, peace. Have a good night, y'all. Later.